elastic cartilage with or sin hematoxylin staining from the epiglottis in this case. On both sides of the epiglottis, you have an epithelial layer. This may be either on both sides a stratified squamous non-keratinizing epithelium, or on one side the stratified squamous non-keratinizing epithelium, and on the other side a pseudostratified columnar ciliated epithelium. In this case, on both sides, you would see the stratified squamous non-keratinizing epithelium. Underneath the epithelium, on both sides, you see a loose connective tissue with nice blood vessels, occasionally nerves here. These blood vessels we will learn at the end of the semester. Just as an example here, this is an artery, the internal elastic membrane, the muscular layer, and the external elastic membrane. This is a vein with scattered elastic fibers, and there you see the cross-section of a nerve. But now let's see the elastic cartilage. This is here the elastic cartilage territory. On both sides you have the perichondrium, the chondrogenic layer, the newly formed chondroblasts as they are multiplying and forming the isogenous groups. In the intercellular territory, you have a meshwork of elastic fibers, which are stained here well with orsin, but you have also collagen type 2 fibers. Collagen type 2 fibers come in the hyaline cartilage and in the elastic cartilage. The elastic cartilage doesn't calcify with age. It will preserve its elasticity until the end of your life. Elastic cartilage you may find in the epiglottis and in the ear. On our website, you may find another example for elastic cartilage. This is from the ear. Here you also see the newly formed chondroblasts, the isogenous groups forming larger and larger as we go deeper. In between, we have a delicate meshwork of elastic fibers. You saw previously elastic cartilage in the slide from the epiglottis stained with passage. There we demonstrated for you the pseudostratified columnar ciliated epithelium on the surface, the basement membrane, and underneath in the loose connective tissue in that slide, you had the nice pus positive mast cells. Deeper, you could see also mixed salivary glands, fat tissue, and these islets of elastic cartilage. The epiglottis is pierced by the salivary glands, and if the plane of the cut goes through a tunnel for the glands, then you would think that the cartilage is broken, but it's not broken. It just goes through a gap, the plane of the cut. And if we enlarge this territory, then you will see here also the pus positive material, the glycogen within the cartilage cells. But in the intercellular matrix, when we enlarge it, you see the fibers. So not as in the hyaline cartilage that it was homogeneous. Here you see the meshwork of fibers. The elastic fibers are visible here in between the cells.